As far as helmet stickers, yeah, I gave my helmet sticker on offense to Justin Ross. He had 9 catches for 111 yards and a touchdown. He was the one that had that touchdown they reviewed. They actually called out of bounds initially. Once they reviewed it, they saw he got the toe down. That was a big catch for Clemson as it essentially, you know, stepped on the throat of South Carolina and kind of ended it.
Yeah, I like what Justin Ross did. I'm glad he's kind of getting into form towards the end of the season. And him and Trevor Lawrence are hooking up. Really almost gave this helmet sticker for me to Trevor Lawrence because of how many dimes he just threw that game. But I ended up giving it to Travis Etienne, a guy who has a multiple winner this season. A guy we're going to miss dearly for sure, but he breaks the ACC career touchdown and rushing touchdown records. 57 touchdowns career, 53 rushing touchdowns total. So I give him the helmet sticker on offense. Man, just what a great and awesome running back he's been for Clemson Tigers. I believe either The Roar or Kelly Gramlich came out and asked, is Travis Etienne the best running back Clemson has ever had? I'd say he'd be up there for sure. He's going to be somebody who I think, if you really look at it on an individual standpoint, without having to share time with someone like a James Davis, having to really be relied on for everything, because Tavian Feaster didn't turn out to be that James Davis type person. He kind of just turned out to be kind of like a consistent, reliable running back, but not a guy who was going to take over or ever be a starter kind of guy. But when Etienne came in and what he did, growing himself up and becoming, you know, basically a preseason Heisman candidate, I think, you know, if you look at his whole body of work, you know, for me, I've always been a CJ Spiller lover, and I have his jersey signed and autographed to me, but I've got a feeling that I need to go get me a number 9 jersey.
Yeah, you've been on the Travis Etienne train, obviously, from the beginning of the season, pushing him for the Heisman. You know, so I'm a little disappointed that you say he would be up there. Okay, look, I haven't been on the Travis Etienne train, but I've always loved Travis Etienne. He's a great running back, and there's no question about it. He is the best running back in Clemson history. Okay, you look at the stats, look at what he's done, and he's, you know, he barely plays in the third quarter half the time. He is the best running back in Clemson football history. I mark the tape. It doesn't matter what you say. It's happening. Hopefully, we have another one like him soon, but I doubt that because he can just do it all, man. That guy with the ball in his hands is absolutely fantastic to watch, and we knew that was going to be the case a couple years ago for sure. So we're really going to miss him this year, definitely. What do you got on the defensive side of the ball there, Morgan? What you got for your defensive helmet sticker?
Well, for defense, I really, you know, a guy I also love from the beginning of the season, that's DK. Mm-hmm. Darion Kendrick had a nice interception at the beginning of the game. It kind of set up after that failure on the goal line, which, to be honest with you, if you look back at it, Travis Etienne didn't hit the hole. I mean, there was a hole there, and he went to the right instead of going straight. And so I believe he could have got a touchdown there. But Darion Kendrick was able to get the interception off of Helinski, and it kind of set the tone to say, hey, you know, you got no chance in this game, and kind of – Clemson took it and scored right after that. So give me DK on defense with the helmet sticker.
Yeah, and that's a good pick there. I actually did mean to mention that there was a hole in one of those plays that Travis Etienne actually missed. But hey, then you saw it later in the game. They gave him the ball and ran to the outside, and what did he do? He walked in. All right, that's kind of what I'm looking for there. Get him in space. He'll beat a player one-on-one every single time. On defense, I actually went with Isaiah Simmons. Go figure, right? Same old for Isaiah Simmons. 10 tackles, 7 solo attack, and 2 tackles for loss. A sack and 2 tackles for loss. I mean, this guy's crazy good. I think he may be the player we miss the most going into next year. And that's saying a lot when you're losing a Travis Etienne and you're losing a T. Higgins or somebody like that. But Isaiah Simmons has just been a do-it-all on defense. He's kind of the player that strikes fear in, you know, in the eyes of the opponent. So it's going to be tough to be without him, you know, kind of running around and making every play known to man. But, you know, he's been good for the Tigers, so we'll wish him well for sure. Hope to see him do big things in the pros. But I gave him my defensive helmet sticker.
For the $2 bill, that's what we give to the team, you know, the best performer on the other team, the opposing team. What did you have? Who did you have that you picked for the Gamecocks? They didn't get much going, so it's kind of hard to pick from. Don't tell me you picked the punter again.
I didn't pick the punter again. I could have, but I didn't. I picked somebody. I'm not sure if I can pronounce her name. I picked Kingsley Enigbare. He had 6 tackles with a sack and a tackle and a half for loss. Look, he gave the best effort, and he also gave the most dirty play when he nailed Trevor Lawrence in the back after the ball had been thrown. I think that was a pretty egregious foul there. He did get called for it. But, you know, karma actually reared its ugly head late in the game. He kind of left with an injury there later. So it kind of all comes back around. But yeah, that was a really dirty hit. Unfortunately, very disappointed to see that. It's something that can not only ruin a game, but ruin a career in a heartbeat. So luckily, Trevor kind of escaped unscathed from that.
For me, it's the white towel chain. That's who I'm giving my helmet sticker for. I couldn't bring myself to pick an actual player in this game. So I went with that nice, I don't know if you know what I'm talking about. You know, they give you white towels, which how much money do they spend on these ridiculous towels? But they have white towels at the on the stadium seats. And then towards the third quarter, the South Carolina fans, there were not very many left, but they were also so bored that they started tying them together to see how long they could create the chain. And I thought, you know what? Golf clap. Great job. You know, that is the best use of your time in that situation is to try to make something out of nothing. And anything that has a Gamecock on it is definitely worth nothing. And so to try to make something out of that, like a giant rope is, you know, pretty impressive.
Yeah.
I got to say, not Clemson engineer impressive, but definitely South Carolina engineer impressive. So